Hello everyone and welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's video, we're diving into Milanote. I reviewed Milanote a fair while ago now, but in today's video, we're giving it a full recap, giving you a bit of an insight into what's changed in the last year or so since we've reviewed it. For those who don't know, Milanote is a creative planning workspace for you to map out ideas, thoughts, boards, tasks, pretty much anything. And it's really perfect for creatives, designers, and even those casual graphic designers, etc. All those who love to visually create. So in today's video, let's explore Milanote. So hello everyone and welcome back to another video. As you can see by this video, we are taking a look at Milanote. You can find Milanote at milanote.com. And as I was mentioning, it's a place for planning creative projects and activities. This is its lovely homepage. It's been around for a fair while now. It's got an iOS application coming very soon, but right now it's only available through web. Now I'm going to just log in. I've got a free account, so I'll be demoing what I have inside of my account and also showcasing you around the application. Then we're going to talk about a few of the things that have changed. So hopefully this video gives you a bit of an insight. So as you can see, this is the Milanote workspace. As you can see, I've gone into this board. So I'm actually going to go back to the homepage. You can see here that you basically get to create your own workspace. So it's really, really simple. You obviously got these interactive elements. Think of this as a canvas in front of you, a creative canvas. Now I've created different areas from my previous video. So as you can see, personal and professional. That's really simple to do. And all you have to do is drag on the board section. And they're basically a new area. Think of a new page inside of Notion. So I'm just going to create a new area and title it new area. Actually, let's make it something a bit more interesting, like creative ideas. And as you can see, an icon has been assigned to it. If I wanted to change the color, I can do. Let's make it a blue, and I can change the icon too. You can also give a few more icons that are related to it, the keywords they bring up, or even upload your own image. Now, if I wanted to and change the icon to maybe a piggy bank with a little icon there. Now, you can lock the position of it. So, for example, if you had your own structural laid out in front of this, then you can do this lovely locking so that it doesn't move. Now, if I go back out of here and I click in, it creates this own workspace here. And as you can see, this canvas allows you to start adding stuff. So if I wanted to start, you know, mapping out ideas, I could add an image, for example. If I click it, you can see a recommended images, and you can even see that it's Google searched a few things ready for you. So the two keywords, creative idea, but you can upload your own, and that's really, really easy to do. So let's upload an example. Let's upload some of this inspiration that I have. And as you can see, it goes automatically into unsorted, which you can drag it out to. You can make it larger. And as you can see, you can position it anywhere you like. If I click into this, I can actually give it to a color. That means it gives like this almost like banner across the top. And I could also add a caption too. I can say like Japanese style building, if I wanted to, and that caption just goes below it. You can see when I added the caption, I also had the ability to go bold, italic, even add a hyperlink, as well as highlight, strike through, and add some code. So it does have quite a few abilities there. If I click into it again, I can lock the position of that, and that's fixed. So for example, when I come to try and move it across, it won't do anything. Now you can add lots of different things to this board. It can be a note, for example. You can have a really simplistic note if you wanted to, something that you could just start going into, like for example, if you put Japanese style building, and you could maybe add some notes next to it. You could even add bullet points. So let's try to apply this style to a new house. I don't know, maybe this person's building a house. And you can click in and even do all the same. You've also got something called power-ups, which has been something they've recently added. So for example, if you wanted to convert it to a long form piece, and that's just make it scrollable, you know, like a almost in its own page, then you can do, and that's perfect for designers. That almost collaborates as a document there. So that's something that you can do with power-ups. You can switch that off as well. You can also add a separate like description that's just an additional field, as well as make it transparent too. So if you wanted to make that note just like clear, then you can do. Now, power-ups are a fairly new feature, so that's something that they're going to be rolling out. Now, one of the things I missed in here is I just wanted to make this this heading, just heading one, so that can be nice and clear. And if I wanted to, I could do something very similar to what you could do in Google Keep, but I guess just have the banner up there. So it gives it kind of a nice structure when you're finding different notes. Now, you can also add links, hyperlinks, that is. So for example, if I found a really good article, let's find an article on Japanese art. Let's paste the link here and press enter. And as you can see, what should appear is a full bleed article on this. So that's quite a nice addition. If I wanted to put this one over here, then that means that I can click into that whenever I want any inspiration to it. Now, you can also do to-do lists as well. So for example, if I dragged it on, you can see a to-do list appears. Now, it's a very simple to-do list. You can add a title to it. So for example, if you wanted like a list of places to visit in Japan. Okay, so I'm gonna not lie to you guys, I definitely use Siri there to ask what places in Japan I could visit so that I knew exactly what to put there. So you can see a good demonstration of how the list works here, particularly like the organizing list. So for example, you can move and change and tick off any of the list items too. So for example, I could say I visited Nagoya. I'm probably butchering that pronunciation. If I wanted to, I could add a line too. Now the line could be manipulated, and also you can add a curve to that line too. So for example, if you're visually demonstrating something, then you can do so. If I just get rid of that one, you can also add a board. So you're almost adding pages inside of this. So for example, if you want to add something specific, like for example, the building designs, I don't know, then you could have something that resembles that. And obviously that would be clickable and the breadcrumb would appear at the top of the page. You've also got a column too. If you drag a column out, they almost act as boards. So for example, if I just typed in board and added a card to it just below. So if I put something like alternative places in Japan, and I clicked off this, you can see that the card becomes available. And if I click in and click out, you can drag the card out too. Now that's a very smart thing that you can do. And the board obviously allows you to add all of the text formatting abilities that you do there. So it's almost like having a mini board inside of here. But again, these are the title of boards inside of here. So they're called columns, they're called boards. Now you can also add a comment, which is helpful if you are a team member, and you can obviously tag people relevant to the comment. So why not try another look? And you could post it here. And as you can see, that will appear inside of something called notifications in the top right if you had a team added to it. Now you can upload files, and something I want to talk about near the end is templates. But this is that's a general view of all of the features. If I go up to the top right, you can invite other people to edit, to view and leave documents, or just send a read-only version, as well as a secret link to this board so that it will be viewable. Now, something that's brand new in this edition is, well, since last time we reviewed it, is the ability to export in PNG. I don't think that was available. You can export in PDF. You can also convert it to a linear document, like a PDF, a Word document, Markdown, or plain text, which is very good. So up here, obviously you've got, I'm on the free plan, but very similar to the likes of Notion, you've got a limit of how many insights you've got. So for example, on my one, I've used 28 of the 200 used so far. Now, if you had, for example, you have seven notes, that's seven notes, one comment, four images, one link, 15 to-do lists, and you can get, okay, it looks like I've earned 100 cards, extra cards, but you can get, there's like a referral scheme in here. If you click refer a friend, you can copy and increase it by 200 cards, 20 cards each time. So there's a maximum of 100. So I think that I've done that before, but if you're looking for more, then you can do. As you see, you get 100 notes as your sort of minimum, and you can add up to 100 cards with no time limit either. So that's the plans there. You've got the free plan for sharing unlimited boards. You've got the ability to add 100 notes and upload 10 files. Whereas with this professional monthly one, it's a pro account, it's $9.99, and that's billed annually. But if you wanted to build monthly, that's $12.50. Everything on free plan, unlimited notes, unlimited boards, unlimited search as well. So that's in the upgrade. So, as you can imagine, probably something for you to explore. But what I want to quickly do is demonstrate the new templates function. This is something that's only been added recently, I'd say, probably something that's been added in the last year at least. And you can see that there are some popular templates. So you can see a weekly plan's been already created as a board. So if I go into it, you can see a weekly plan structure has been laid out. So you can copy that. You can basically change it to whatever you want. And you can also clear example content. So you can just start fresh. That's something I wish I would have seen inside of Notion. And I'm sure they'll probably be adding it soon. If you wanted to, you can add another board or another page inside of here. And as you can see, this is a nice team planner, what's on my list to do. And also I've got like creative briefs, persona. These are all things that designers will use. There's even a design section. So if you want a design brief, let me just demonstrate that because I know a few designers follow this channel. So you can see here that you've got a few design briefs, a layout about the client and things like that. So you can view all of them. They've got more than just that. Project workflow, social media, video creative brief, project plan. Sales pipeline might be useful. I know a lot of sales individuals use it. As you can see, these are the actions. So as you can see, you've got a nice column here with the ability to see all of the notes from the meeting and the actions below. So that's quite a nice addition. So there are a few examples you could use for templates. But again, one thing that I wanted to mention is the iOS application is coming out. Currently only available through web. Works really well. One thing I would say is it's a lot smoother than the first time I tried it a year ago now. So I think they've worked on the stability of it. But I'm going to see how the iOS app comes out because a lot of the time, like with the likes of Notion, it's going to be hard to try and replicate, especially how visual this experience is, to create in the iOS experience. So I'm looking forward to seeing how they make a take on it anyway. Anyway, guys, hopefully that gave you a nice review or overview of Milanote. Again, it's a very competitive application. They're looking to develop further, but they're really trying to hone in. This is really perfect for those designers out there, those creatives, and those people who'd like to collaborate. Now, one thing I want to say is there is a Mac app coming too, I believe. So do check that one out. I'm not sure whether it's readily available yet, so I'll include the link in the description. Anyway, guys, huge thank you for stopping by. If you're brand new to the Keep Productive YouTube channel, feel free to hit subscribe and the bell notification to get regular videos. We're doing a daily video here in November, so it'd be great to have you as a routine subscriber. Anyway, guys, thank you so much, and I will see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.